friend as a dear brother.
Because if you see that YMCA just over there, many, many years ago when I was a CEO of YMCA, Edward was still then one of the 16 board of directors. And that kind of friendship, brotherhood in the same spirit during that time, or even and from then until now, is so deep, so deep, so deep.
Amen.
In the sense that, like him and the other 15 board of directors, somehow, very divinely, I never expected, because I always in the corporate world with the MNCs and, you know, American MNCs and British MNCs. And actually, thinking of that, this place is very special. Special in the sense that now I just recollecting as I was sitting down there, that last time in the 80s, I actually work, is it upstairs or downstairs with Hopa? Hopa office was
Hopa
here.
Was
here. So when I, is it on this same floor? Oh, okay. So it's actually very dear to me that when I came back from London in the 80s, my first job was with Hopa. And so this is very dear to me. I was here a couple of years reporting to the CEO at that time. So very special, and then very special with Edward here, because that time, for some reason, I didn't even know who was my predecessor. I didn't know him. He resigned for whatever reason. I didn't know. Then, long story short, I was to social contact and all that. I was asked to be the one who replaced him. After prayer, I did. Although that time I was with Chevron, he said, no, you cannot go. Because you are so successful in bringing the business for Chevron that we could not break through for 6 years in Asia. With all the muscle, financial muscle, manpower of Chevron, we could have no problem. We even own Caltex, you know, in all parts of Asia. Although many Asia do not know about Chevron, but you know about Caltex, right? And yet, they could not break through the market. For some reason, I was invited to work for them to see whether I can break through the market. And during that 5 years, somehow the Lord just touched the marketplace, especially China, Indonesia, and you can say that in a very funny way, since Kai is from Indonesia, the most difficult country in terms of corruption, bribery, the most successful, the Lord touched where I go, in terms of where to go, who to meet, who not to meet, where not to go, what contract to sign, what contract not to sign, and at this distance, if you hold up the documents, the Holy Spirit says that is fake. Don't sign that. Or that is the correct one. You sign that. Wow. This is the power of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. So, I was so blessed and successful in the marketplace that Chevron leadership in San Francisco was wondering, how on earth that Chevron with all this financial muscles and manpower and everything, the network of Caltex and so on, we could not break through. And how come for you, just with a PA, a secretary, and you just travel, you know, a short period of time, you can break through all the marketplace. Most difficult one, especially Indonesia, Malaysia, China. And I said, I plan, I strategize, but my Jesus helped me. And they say, wow. So that's the reason. Huh? I say, it must be. Because it cannot be that some of the things, even though with my whatever training I have in London, you know, my gifting is international marketing, management, leadership, and all that. But even that, I would not be able to know some of the things that, how do I know, like, Kai Distan, I know that that document is fake. And that one with you is the correct one. Sign that, don't sign this. There's no way I would know it. So it must be my God.
Amen.
Amen? Yes. And they say, wow, so that is the reason. I say, it must be. And it was during that time, YMCA invited me to be the CEO during that time. And I said, why do you need me? Because I do not have YMCA, that kind of background in terms of social, you know, so a lot of social functions, membership, and so on and so on. And I remember the two directors said that for some reason we want to bring the YMCA, the C, bigger. I said, oh, I said, that I can understand. So, long story short, I talked to Chevron. Chevron wouldn't let me go. And then ultimately, with the caveat, with the promise that we can only let you go for 1 year. And that's it. And you have to come back. So, I have to go to YMCA, the board, and I said that, well, my employer wouldn't allow me to go, but they did say with this caveat of 1 year. So I can be only in YMCA for 1 year, unless whatever happened later on or in between.